me start again.
Good. I do not have your patience, so I'm driving up to Chicago. I'm getting weird looks at gas stations. I did not bring a winter coat. I do not have your foresight. A holistic practitioner told me once, it's why I will not live a long life. I am trying to remember where I gave up. If it was not in Iowa, Iowa, somewhere in the middle of the Great Plains, I saw.
Hi, so I wanted to do a monthly reading wrap up for January 2022. I've read 4 books this month and I'm on my 5th. We have about a week left until the end of the month, but I've got a lot on for the last week. So, I don't know if I'll finish this last book this week, but well, I'll have to, actually. Anyway, I won't really talk about this book that much because I'm not that far through it. However, I wanted to talk about the other 4 books that I read this month and what they're like, what I think of them, what I rated them, my experience with them. There is a book that is quite hyped in here, and I'll tell you my experience reading it. I've also read books that have a TV show with them, and then a book from one of my favorite authors. Also a new author, actually 2 new authors in this one that I'm exploring. So pretty much the whole month I have just read romance. I've been in a really big romance like book reading. I really love romance at the moment. I don't think I'll ever stop loving romance. But yeah, so I started off the year with Bridgeton, The Duke and I. I gave this book 3 stars. Barely 3 stars, honestly. The only reason I gave it 3 stars is because I enjoyed it. However, it wasn't that great. There's a scene in here that I didn't like. It was sort of added in there for shock value and wasn't that great. I think that Julia could have, I can't remember her last name. Julia Quinn. I think that Julia Quinn could have explored the and talked about that a little bit more, and from each side what was going on. This book is dual point of view, and it's not like dual point of view through each chapter changing, it just changes. Although I kind of liked that didn't bother me. However, I know that bothers some people. You will know when it changes, and she makes it pretty obvious when it is changing between the two. I enjoyed the story between Daphne and the Duke. I did enjoy it. It has a fake dating trope, which I liked. I love fake dating. It's one of my favorite tropes. So that might also be why I enjoyed it so much. And then the second book was from the Bridgeton series as well, and that was the second book in the series, which is The Viscount Who Loved Me. Let me get the book actually. Then I read The Viscount. Mariana Loved Me. I actually bought this book because I just really wanted to get to it. I really wanted to get to Colin's book, but I wanted to get to Colin's book in the library, and they didn't have it. They didn't have Anthony's book, which is This Is the Loose Anthony. Oh, the smell left the place. Let me start again. This is the Viscount Who Loved Me, and this follows Anthony and I can't remember her name. Kate. Anthony and Kate. And it is an enemies to lovers. I really enjoyed this. I gave it a 3.5 stars. I thought this was so cute and adorable. However, I hated Anthony for most of the book, not gonna lie. And I loved Kate throughout the entire book. Kate is so cute and so wholesome, and they honestly have so much in common. But yeah, I really liked it. I would recommend this one in the Bridgeton series. The first one, not so much. I don't even really think that you need to read the first one either. Anthony's book is so much better. So much better. And I love, love, love this book. Then the next book I read was Kulti by Mariana Zapata. Now, Mariana Zapata is becoming one of my favorite authors. I love what she does with her characters. I love how funny and honest her books are, and how they really do feel like real people when I read them. Like, it feels like I should be able to just search up Kulti and him be there and him be with Sal. And I'm kind of annoyed that it's not. But I just adored this book. I gave this book 5 stars. It was incredible. I loved Sal in this book. I loved Kulti. I loved their relationship. I loved everything. A lot of people say that it's enemies to lovers. It's not really, in my opinion. He just gets on her nerves at the start, and he's a bit of a dick. Yeah. So Sal is a professional soccer player. Professional women's soccer player, and Kulti is a retired professional men's soccer player that is now her coach. And he's also really famous. And it's her story of them sort of getting to know each other, and him being a bit of a dick at times and being really stuck up and exploring why he's like that. And yeah, I just really adored it. Please go and read it. Please, 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 please. It's so incredible. I love Mariana Zapata. I love her books so, so much. She's so incredible. She's honestly one of my favorite writers. I just want to go out and buy all her books. My favorite character is Sal's dad. 100%. He is so cute and so funny and so adorable. I highly recommend reading it. So then I DNF'd a book. So I started reading The House of Leaves, I think it's called. It's an Australian book by an Australian author. I just went into this thinking that it was a thriller or a horror, and it's not. I opened up the book, I hated the writing. I just did not like it. I just didn't like the atmosphere. I didn't like anything about it. I just wanted to close it and kind of put it away. It is not a book for me. So I just DNF'd that. Maybe one day I'll pick it up, but I highly doubt it. I just really didn't enjoy it. Always there when you call. Always on time. Gave you my. Baby, be mine. Always there when you call. Always on time.
wanna swing like no other. I know I got a lot of things I need to explain, but baby, you know the name.
Let's take.